In this example, we're asked to determine how many distinct sets of 111 planes are present in a single crystal that has the face center cubic structure. And planes that are parallel to each other are considered in the same set of planes. So we're looking at how many distinct sets of different parallel planes we have. And then we want to look at what they are. So first, let's look at what corresponds to a 111 plane. The idea of Miller indices is that the intercepts, if we were to pick, for example, here as our center of our axis, our 0, 0, 0 point, and we wanted to look at the Miller indices where the intersections are 1, 1, and 1 in the three axes, then we end up with a plane that corresponds to the 111 plane. So here I've colored in this plane to make it easy to see what we're referring to. Now the question is, if we pick a different point as our origin, again look at the same intercepts, do we have other planes? The answer is yes. So let's look at another point. Here I've picked this point 2 as our origin, and then I have intercept 1, 1, and 1 for the three axes, and we can see we have a plane that's not parallel to the first one, so we have at least 2. So let's now pick a third location for our origin. So I've used 3 as the origin, and again had intercepts 1 unit cell distance at the three axes, and now I have a third plane. Remember, this corresponds to a whole set of planes that is not parallel to these first two. And then finally, I can do it for a fourth. So when I pick point number 4 as the origin, look at the intercepts. Again, I have a 111 plane, and it's not parallel to these other three. So we have at least 4 sets of 111 planes. Now the question might be asked, well, we have 4 other corners of this square unit cell. How about if we pick one of those? So let's look at one of those and see what happens. So I've picked point 5, which is diagonally across from point 4. Again, I have a 111 plane, but this 111 plane is parallel to the 111 plane we got when we picked the diagonal corner, namely the corner 4 as the origin. We haven't identified a new set of 111 planes. Instead, just picked one that's parallel to it. And so here I've shown that, of course, there's unit cells in all directions. I've drawn the next unit cell to the right to demonstrate how these planes are parallel in a whole set of planes going out in this direction. So the ones that have 4 as the origin here is representing 2 of the unit cells. And of course, we have unit cells for a long distance. We have 4 sets of 111 planes that are not parallel to each other. We can look at a ball and model structure a little bit to visualize what these look like. So this corresponds to looking down on a unit cell. For example, if we looked at this drawing with the origin number 1 and we looked at it from underneath, so this purple atom corresponds to the atom 1. And then what we're going to have in contact with that atom are going to be atoms on the surface, and that's these 3 atoms. And then we're going to have atoms on the corners that are part of the plane, namely this one, and this one, corresponding to these 3 atoms. And so the 111 face center cubic plane is the close-packed plane with the hexagonal symmetry. We can imagine if we were at this corner, it would look the same. If now this purple atom corresponds to the atom on this corner, and we took away the purple atom to see the 111 plane, we would then be looking at the 3 corner atoms here. And then the atoms on the face, namely this face, and this face, and this face, that would give us this 111 plane. You can also look at a video that shows this three-dimensional version rotating, so it's easy to see these 111 planes in the face center cubic structure.